स्टेप नंबर सिक्स, कैलकुलेशन ऑफ डी टू. डी टू इज पॉसिबल बाय टू मेथड्स. The first one is, say, a detailed method in which it is ln s divided by e plus rf minus variance divided by 2 whole into time period divided by under root of t into standard deviation. This is a formula which we are supposed to apply for the purpose of calculation. It is 0.0769617 plus RF stands for risk-free rate of return, which is 6%. Variance is 0.11 divided by 2. Whole into time period, and that is 0.50. Whole divided by under root of the time period into standard deviation, that is under root of the variance. This is the way we make the calculation of answer. So 0.11 divided by 2 is 0.055. That is subtracted from 0.06. So 0.005 into 0.5. So 0.0025. Again, friends, this value will be found first. It will be deducted from 0.06. Whatever the answer that we have will be multiplied with 0.50 plus 0.0769617. Whole divided by root of 0.5 and root of 0.11. So 0.2345. Point 0769617 plus 0.0025 divided by 0.2345. So 0.3389. This is a very detailed method by which you can do the answer, or otherwise there is an alternative method also. The alternative method will work like this. It is d1 minus denominator, that is under root of the time period into standard deviation. This is the way we are required to calculate the answer. The value of the d1 is 0.5734. Minus under root of 0.5 into under root of 0.11. That is under root of the variance. So 0.5734 minus directly this value. So 0.2345. That is 0.3389. That is a way D2 value can be found. Step number 7. calculation of n d2, that is normal probability distribution of d2 value. So it is d2 and z table d2. So it is 0.3389. So we understand that's a 33 and 34. So it is 0.33 and 0.34. So 0.1293 and 1331. So 0.1293 and 0.1331. Difference of the first two is 0.01 and difference of the second two is 0.1331 minus 0.1293, 0.0038. Okay, now we understand that so usually we will take the base of the lower one, so this 0.0089. So 0.1293 plus 0.0038 divided by 0.01 into 0.0089. This is the way we will have so the Z table reading. So 0.1293 plus 0.0038 into 0.0089 divided by 0.01. So 0.0034. Plus 0.1293. So 0.1327. This is the way we will have the Z table reading of D2 value. Dear students, based on that, we'll compute the ND2. It is 0.50 plus 0.1327, so 0.6327. That is the way ND2 can be found. Once we compute ND2, then we'll make the calculation of step number 8. Calculation of VC, that is value of call, or it is given a name as call premium. It will be computed something like this. Spot into ND1 minus exercise price into ND2 into e raised to negative RF into T. This is the formula to be applied. Spot price of equity share is 27. ND1 that we have found is 0.7168 minus exercise price is 22, so 25 into ND2 is 0.6327. Into e raised to negative RF into T, 0.97045. So friends, in step number 2, we have computed e raised to negative RF into T. So we understand 27 into 0.7168, so 19.3536. 25 into 0.6327 into 0.97045, 15.35. So the answer is 19.3536 minus 15.35. So it is 4.0036. Or we can say that it is 4 rupees. That is the way the call premium can be found. Once value of the call is done, then we will compute the calculation of put premium. Step number 9, calculation of put premium. For that, say we will apply the put call parity theorem. So it is value of put plus spot is equal to present value of exercise price plus spot price of equity share. Sorry, plus value of call. This is the way we will make the computation of, say, the put premium. So, value of put is equal to exercise price into e raised to negative RF into t plus value of call is call premium, that is 4 rupee 4.0036. Minus spot price of security. What is exercise price? Exercise price is 25. Into e raised to negative 0.06 raised to 6 divided by 12. Plus 4.0036 minus spot price of equity share is 27. So 25 into 0.970945 plus 4.0036 minus 27. This is the way the put premium can be found. 25 into 0.970945. So 24.26125 plus 4.0036 minus 27. So it comes to 1 rupee 27 paise or 26 paise. That is the put premium. So summary, step number 1 not applicable, revise the spot price. Step number 2 e raised to negative RF into t, that is 0.97045. Step number 3, I think that's this is what's the step that is important, ln s divided by e. Step number 4, it is D1 calculation. The sequence in which you have to solve the equation is important. Step number 5 is ND1. In that, say, first of all, we are required to find the Z table reading. Then it is to be added because the D1 value is positive. Step number 6 is D2, in which you have to apply a simple formula, or there is a shortcut method by which you can do it. Subsequent step is ND2. Then calculation of the value of call, that is call premium, and value of put, that is put premium. This is the way we are required to make the computation of the premium.